A moment of casual chatter. Then the shots start. This is the last moment we see Shireen Abu Akleh walking with colleagues, seemingly at ease. Seconds later, she's lying motionless on the ground.
I just watch her and there is no up and down. She didn't breathe. And this is make me crazy. Why she didn't breathe? And the shooting is I still hearing.
Shada Hanesha has become a key eyewitness to the May 11th shooting of Abu Akleh. She and eight others present told CNN it was the Israel Defense Forces that shot her and that they thought it was deliberate.
But I think they want to kill us. This is why they shoot. I don't have another reason why they shoot. And they know we are journalists.
It felt targeted.
Yeah, because all the time when I tried to touch her body, that they're shooting on me or around me.
The gunfire you hear at the beginning of this clip is key. Eyewitness testimony and audio analysis show these are the shots that kill Abu Akleh. There is a crack and then a pop. The time between these two sounds reveals how far away the gunmen are. This indicates a distance of between 177 and 197 metres, according to forensic audio analyst Rob Mayer. The tree next to where Abu Akleh was shot is also a crucial piece of evidence. This is her colleague Mujahid Asadi, another eyewitness retracing his steps days later. The bullet holes on the tree now identified with tape. Military analyst Chris Cobb-Smith told CNN that the nature of the strike marks proved this wasn't a random shot. She was targeted. He said there was no chance that random firing would result in the three or four shots hitting in such a tight group from a distance of 200 metres. Based on this analysis, we looked for potential perpetrators in the surrounding area. Less than 3 minutes before Abu Akleh is shot, this Israeli military truck is visible within 200 metres down the same road. The number one can be seen on the side. The truck can be seen from this angle too in these videos uploaded to Telegram, this time with armed soldiers visible. Multiple eyewitnesses said a sniper fired at them from a window in an IDF truck. The IDF's own body cam footage shared of the operation that morning shows the same military vehicles lined up on the street facing down towards Abu Akleh. CNN geolocated these videos to this location, matching the distance estimated in Mayer's audio analysis. This is also corroborated by the IDF's interim report. The IDF insists they do not deliberately target non-combatants and have said Abu Akleh could have been killed by gunfire from Palestinian militants.
The Israeli government has said that there were also Palestinian gunmen in that area and that it could have been either. You were there. What did you see?
I absolutely doesn't agree that there is any Palestinian guy with his gun. And as a journalist and as a human, I will not make myself in a dangerous situation.
This video appears to back Hanesha's version. The nearest location where CNN has found armed people present, according to verified video evidence uploaded the morning of May 11th, is here, the other side of the IDF forces, therefore without a clear line of fire to Abu Akleh and beyond the 200-metre reach of the gunfire. In fact, the video of Abu Akleh's last moments also shows the street has no ongoing clashes or crossfire. It leaves the IDF vehicles as the closest and most likely source of the gunfire. And while there is yet to be an official determination on who killed Abu Akleh, these testimonies and videos are compelling evidence that the Israeli government must answer to. Katie Polglase, CNN, London.